Family members, friends, and fellow travelers, it is wonderful to see each of you today on this momentous occasion. Welcome to the 2021 Acton Academy Launchpad graduation ceremony. To begin, please rise for the processional as our six graduates enter together. Evelyn, Sam, Paige, Caitlin, Luca, and Chris. The hero's journey is a metaphor for your lives. And each hero's journey consists of numerous smaller journeys. This moment marks the end of one journey and the beginning of another, as you will soon cross the threshold outside and formally embark on your next great adventure. While the hero's journey is an individual struggle, victories mean little unless they are shared with others in a community. We will begin today's ceremony by honoring each of your journeys with a heartfelt slideshow created by none other than your fellow travelers.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a good time. I feel like I'm high. And the world turning inside out. I'm so in ecstasy, so don't stop. Thank you, Eagles, for all the hard work you put into creating that wonderful momentum. We will all cherish these memories. Chris, Evelyn, Caitlin, Luca, Paige, and Sam, you have heard the call to adventure and heroically embraced launching into the beauty of the unknown. You are an extraordinary group, and the events of the last year have also been extraordinary. The world has never needed you more than this very moment. Before we hear the commencement address and confer your diplomas, we want to pause and honor each of you for your unique contributions to the life of Acton Academy. Each of you will soon receive a small treasure, a symbol of the light that is inside each of you. When I call your name, please come to the front to receive your award and then return to your seat afterwards. Luca, you have... No, you can... You can stay seated. You have heart and soul and an unflappable confidence. You have an inner compass and a spirit that is both true and good. One of our first graduates, Sager Williams, possessed many of these qualities. Luca, today we award you with the Sager Williams Compass Award. Congratulations. Evelyn, you discovered your inner gifts through perseverance and grit, never giving up or lowering your standards when it would have been easy to do so. The treasure is what the hero's journey is all about, but only when used to serve others. One of our first graduates, Sarah Fisher, carried many of these traits as well. Evelyn, today we award you with the Sarah Fisher Treasure Award. Congratulations, Evelyn. Caitlin, your positivity is felt across the campus. You are a light to so many. As a graduating Eagle, you have led the charge without complaint and with a deep sense of gratitude for those who walked before you. Your work in Launchpad and the elementary school studio has helped forge a path for young people all across the world. One of our first graduates, Ellie Carpenter, shared many of those attributes. Caitlin, today we award you with the Ellie Carpenter Founder Award. Congratulations, Caitlin. Paige, you have been a role model since your arrival. You never wavered from the narrow path of the hero's journey because your character guided you. With your focus always fixed on a true north, you have inspired a generation of young people both on this campus and around the world. One of our first graduates, Sager Williams, possessed many of those qualities. Paige, today we also award you with the Sager Williams Compass Award. Congratulations. Mm-hmm.
Sam, your journey at Acton Academy began in 2009. As one of seven founding Eagles, your steadfast commitment to Acton has been unwavering. In the face of trials and tribulations, you stood true to the Acton principles of hard work, freedom, and responsibility. Today, we share the Loyalty Award with you, which will be bestowed on future graduates as the Sam Sandifer Loyalty Award. Congratulations, Sam. Chris, your journey at Acton also began in 2009. You too were one of seven founding Eagles, a pioneer amongst thousands of young people now at other Actons who have followed in your footsteps. During this time, your morals were never in question. Your honesty and insincerity were unparalleled and will never be forgotten. Today, we share the Integrity Award with you, which will be bestowed on future graduates as the Chris Carpenter Integrity Award. Congratulations, Chris. I am now proud to introduce our commencement speaker this morning. This person is a lifelong entrepreneur who has founded two businesses in Austin. He's an executive producer and a screenwriter. But by far his most important accomplishment, his family is one of only five in the world that can call themselves an Acton Academy founding family. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our commencement speaker and our coach, Mr. Jeff Carpenter.
Are you surprised? Are you a little bit nervous about what I'm going to say? You probably should be. But don't worry, no poems, I promise. Chase, Jeff, Laura, thanks so much for asking me to do this, but I have never delivered a commencement address before, so I thought I should get some advice, right? So the first thing I did is I went to the smartest person I know, honors college student at University of San Francisco, president of Tridel, first ever start to finish graduate of Acton Academy, and I said, honey, I got a big speech coming up to the whole Acton community. Do you have any advice for me? And she did. Do you remember what you said? Do you remember what you said?
Don't blow it.
Don't blow it. That is exactly what she said. So that wasn't that helpful. So next I went to YouTube and I typed in awesome graduation addresses, commencement speeches. Thousands of results. So then I decided to narrow the search. Awesome commencement addresses delivered by the school's PE coach. Results not found. So congratulations, Jeff, Laura, and Chase. You have broken yet another mold. So I'm just going to have to wing it. So guys, I've been thinking long and hard about you for a while, about what's the one skill that you've learned at Acton Academy that's going to help you on your next great adventure. I've been going back and forth on it. First, it was time management. Second, it was public speaking, very important, but I think I got it. I think it is your ability to give and receive constructive criticism to each other in a warm-hearted but tough-minded way. It is so critical. I ask all the parents and people, families, how many times have you all received really helpful constructive criticism in your lives? For me, I can count it on one hand. And I remember every single time because it was so helpful. But it just doesn't happen very much. It sure doesn't happen in most schools. Like, no teacher ever said to me, is this your best work? They just gave me the B- and moved on. And the students sure as heck didn't say, "Is this your best work?" They were hoping it wasn't, so that they could get a better grade than me. That's not the way it works here. You guys are supportive of each other. You help each other. You're here to help each other learn and grow. It's why the community is so awesome, and it's going to help you so much in the future. And you are all awesome at it. I mean, really awesome. I mean, incredibly awesome. You know what? Instead of telling them how awesome you are, why don't we show them how awesome you are at accepting constructive criticism? So I have compiled, based on your careers in my PE class, cool and warm feedback based on your athletic performance over the last 4 to 12 years. Who would like to go first? Evelyn, you'd like to go first? Let's start with Caitlin. I've got it in here somewhere. There you are. Caitlin Dischinger. When you were a freshman at the Acton Olympics, your very first mile run, you ran in 8 minutes and 12 seconds. This is your cool feedback. So I will tell you, 8:12 is pretty good. But I'll never forget, you were huffing and puffing down the stretch, right? And you were just so tired. And I yelled, "Lean in, Caitlin, lean in." But you didn't hear me. You just ran straight upright. You got to it, boom, 8:12. But if you had just leaned in at the finish line, you would have gotten 8:11. But 8:12 is still pretty good. So your cool feedback is, next time, lean in at the finish line. But your warm feedback, no one has worked harder than you at bringing the elementary, the middle school, and the launch pad together. Perfect example, about a year ago, last March, energy was waning in PE, and Caitlin comes up to me and she goes, "Coach, I got an idea. Can we teach the class a dance?" And I said, "Sure, what's it called?" She said, "Church clap." I said, "All right, let's do it." So the boys were kind of, "I don't know," but through Caitlin's energy, she made it happen and we rocked it, right? And at the end you said, "Hey coach, can we perform this in front of the middle school?" I said, "Let's do it." So the middle school comes out, we rock it. And then you said, "Coach, can I teach the middle school how to do this? And then we can show the elementary school." And the whole school by the end of the class was out there watching. And it was amazing. Our energy had never been higher. And that was the last PE class before the pandemic hit. But I will tell you, that memory of you bringing everyone together and having so much fun doing it carried me and all your fellow Eagles a long way into just anticipating and hoping that someday we could all get together again and have fun at PE. Caitlin, I am so happy that you are going to be guiding the elementary school next year. There is no one better. I can't wait to see what you do next, and I'm really going to miss being your coach. Next up, Celestino. First time I met you at the Olympics, you did 47 sit-ups in 60 seconds, which is actually pretty good. But you were so ticked off. Like, when you were done, you, like, stomped off and went over and sat against the fence. Like, "Oh, man." So I walk up to you and I go, "Hey, dude, what's wrong? You did 47 sit-ups. That's awesome." He said, "Yeah, but I could have done more." I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Well, I forgot we were doing this morning. And right before we came here, I had 6 taquitos. And I think the 6th one was a mistake. So your cool feedback is, next time, skip the 6th taquito." But your warm feedback, all right, about 4 months ago, I go to PE and all the girls come buzzing in. It's like, "Coach, guess what?" I said, "What?" "We're playing a basketball game tomorrow night." I said, "I didn't even know we had a team." "We don't." I said, "How many of you have played organized basketball before?" "None of us." "Great, who's your coach?" "Luca." I said, "Okay, this I gotta see." So the next day, in the evening, Chris and I go out to Bastrop, and we sit down, and it's this huge gym, and I see the girls out there kind of milling around the court. A couple of you might have been in jeans. And then Luca shows up and gathers you around and starts running the girls through drills. And by drills, I mean things like, "No, you can't dribble the ball with 2 hands at the same time." And that's what we call a free throw line, right? But his attitude is great, and he's just doing the best he can. And then the other team shows up. And it looks like the Golden State Warriors, right? Shiny uniforms, four head coaches, pack fans coming in. It's crazy. And I'm like, oh, this is not going to be pretty. And it wasn't. We got rolled, right? We got demolished. And it was the fourth quarter. I think it was like 47-2. And the girls were trying so hard and just, you know, I mean, just were exhausted. But we just didn't know how to play, right? And you were just doing your best. But then something magical happened. Brooklyn, could you please rise? Brooklyn somehow steals the ball, dribbles all the way down the court. I think he stole it from their best player. Dribbles the ball down the court, does some Hakeem Olajuwon spin move, triple teamed, throws in a hook shot, bang, bucket. And the place went nuts, right? All the girls on the court just like circled you. They're all jumping up and down. All our fans are excited. Everybody's happy. But what our girls didn't understand is that the ball is still in play. So the other team inbounds it, right? And they start dribbling. And the other team, they're really nice. They're like, let's go, girls, come on. And the refs are like, girls, come on, let's go. And I looked at you, okay? And I will tell you this. A lesser coach would have said, come on, girls, get back on D. Let's go, you know, D up. Not you. You were jumping up and down, celebrating, louder and bigger than anybody else in the whole place. You were in the moment, dude, and you were loving it, and you were getting everybody else to love it, and it was so great. You know what other coach would have reacted just like that? Me. I am so proud of you, dude. You can be a great coach if you want to. You're already a great leader. I can't wait to see what you do next. And I'm really going to miss being your coach. Evelyn Williams. So, cool and warm feedback. Let's start with the cool. One of my proudest achievements as PE coach, no one has ever died during any of my classes. That almost changed when Evelyn was in charge. So in our PE class, we pick leaders for the week, and they get to choose whatever workout they want. Some do cardio, some do weights. Evelyn chose yoga. Evelyn is really, really good at yoga. But sometimes she didn't realize that some teenage boys, without mentioning any names, Patrick, Ian, Mateo, are not as flexible as she might imagine. So I turn my back and I hear, you know, it starts out pretty good. And I hear Evelyn yell, okay, everybody, I think you called it a pretzel pose. Anyway, I turn around and Evelyn's left leg is behind her right ear. Her right arm is underneath her left knee. And it's beautiful and graceful. And I look over at a few of the teenage boys, without naming any names, Patrick, Ian, Mateo, and their faces are turning blue. They are doing the best they can. And right before I call the paramedics, Evelyn says, release! And they release into a ball on the ground, and everything's fine. But your cool feedback is next time, just yell release a little bit earlier. Your warm feedback, why are you graduating in 3 years? Who is going to share my love of Harry Styles' music? It's just you and me. Everybody else hates it. We love it. But your real warm feedback is, I don't know if everybody knows this, Evelyn is graduating in 3 years, okay? Juniors and seniors at Acton do not have to come to my PE class. It's totally optional. Evelyn came to every single one. You might have missed one or two, but you were always there with an awesome attitude, bringing it every time. And it was so motivating to me to see you be there even when you didn't have to. And you had the best excuse in the world. No one's busier than you. And you did it anyway. It was so motivating to all of us and to me. And I'm really going to miss you. And I'm so proud of you. And I can't wait to see what you do next. And I'm going to miss being your coach. Paige Glover, the next Paige. So Paige has been my assistant coach for the last 2 years. And I gotta say, she's really good at it. She always knows when to tell me to switch up the games. She always knows when to tell me to stop playing Thunderstruck on repeat, usually after 4 times. And she always, always brings the heat every time. Doesn't matter what my energy level is. When I see Paige, I know I gotta bring it up. I will ask the launch padders this question. Raise your hand, don't look back, if you think Coach Paige has become a better coach? Don't look back. Then Coach Carpenter. Raise your hand. It's almost unanimous, and the only ones that aren't raising their hands are afraid I'm going to make them do burpees right now. So your cool feedback is, you've become a much better coach than me, and I don't like that. Your warm feedback, on the other hand, I'll never forget the first time I was introduced to the Paige Glover experience. We used to do these thing called lip dubs to start the sessions every year. The goal of it was to build the culture. So we'd spend a week making these lift-up videos that the kids would. And I think it was great in terms of building the culture. It was not great in producing great art. These videos were terrible, right? Awful. And every year, I'd go, oh, don't make me watch another one. But Chris and Ellie come home, and they go, Dad, you got to watch the new lift-up video. I'm like, ah, really? They said, no, this one's different. You're going to like it. I'm like, all right. What's the song? Eye of the Tiger. I'm like, okay, finally a good song. So it comes on. And Chris and Ellie are in the first shot, and they're kind of in the back. Chris is playing the piano, or Ellie's playing the drums. Then all of a sudden, this whirling dervish comes out of nowhere, spins onto the front, right in front of the camera, grabs the mic, says, rising up, and just, I mean, rocks it with all the energy and charisma. And I said to Chris and Ellie, I go, who is this new kid? And they said, that's Paige. I said, well, why is she in the front? Why is the new kid in the front? You two have been here since day one. Why are you in the back? And they said, just wait. And you did. You rocked it, and it was a video worth watching. And seeing you grab that mic, that's all I've ever seen you do since you've been here. You grab the mic. Whether it's creating an award-winning short film, moving to Hollywood for a summer to work on a movie, getting a job on Fear the Walking Dead with no connections, nothing. You just did it. You grabbed the mic. And it is so inspiring to all of us to see you do that. My warm feedback would be to tell you to keep grabbing the mic, but I don't have to tell you that because you're going to do it anyway. I'm really proud of you. I can't wait to see what you do next. And I'm really going to miss being your coach. Sam Sandifer, you knew it was coming. I will say, do you remember when you were 6 years old and I coached you in basketball? You were the worst player on the team. I may or may not have video of Sam dribbling down the court and his shoe flies off. And it flew like 10 feet. And you're like, you look around and you pass the ball to Chris. And then you went over and you grabbed your shoe and you started to put it on very, very slowly. I think the ball went up and down the court 4 different times before you finally got your shoe on. And I, as your coach, I could have called timeout, but I looked over at your mom and dad and you're like, nah, let's let it play out. Let's see what happens. So fast forward 10 years later, I go to PE and I said, hey, Patrick, heard you guys had a game last night, basketball game. He goes, yeah, we lost by 7. I go, that's not bad. And he said, yeah, Sam wasn't there, though. Otherwise, we would have won. I said, Sam who? He said, Sam Sandifer, coach. He's like the best player on the team. I said, what? So I go to your next game, and you're out there blocking shots, making threes, dribbling the ball between your legs. You really were the best player on the team. So my cool feedback for you is you got a lot better at basketball when I stopped coaching you. And I don't like that. But your warm feedback. I've been thinking about how to tell you this. And I don't think I have it yet, because it's very important you hear this. Whenever you start an organization from scratch that's trying to change the world, 2 things are going to happen. You're going to make mistakes, and you're going to get criticized. I know that through my career. Your mom and dad know that. But we're adults. Right? We know what's going to happen getting into it. We're prepared for that. It still hurts, but we can handle it. We have a lifetime of experiences to fall back on. You don't, right? This Acton Academy has been your baby too, but you were 6 and 9 and 12. And as you know, especially in middle school, we had a lot of kids here that this wasn't the right fit for them. And so you've had to hear kids complain a lot over the years. Eagle Bucks, I hate them. This stinks, right? Why do I have to go to school in the summer? This stinks. Can I get one freaking adult answer a question around here? This stinks. And I kept waiting. It would absolutely be your right to get upset, get emotional, get confrontational, because kids always complain about school, but this is your school that you and your family started. I never once saw you act with anything but grace and compassion and humility and restraint. I don't know how you've done it. Ian, Addie, you've been here forever. Have you ever seen him go nuts? Miss Kaylee, you're over here. You've known him longer than anybody. Have you ever seen him react in any way but just pure maturity? Chris, Ellie, Sager? Never. It's been the most amazing example of leadership I've ever seen in my entire life. It's just been incredible, and I'm so proud of you, but I have some good news for you. You're going to Vanderbilt, right? I don't think your parents founded Vanderbilt. You guys didn't found Vanderbilt, did you? Okay, good. So next year when you're at Vanderbilt and somebody comes up to you and they says, man, our football team really stinks. You know what you can say? You can look them in the eye and go, yes, yes it does. So proud of you, bud. I can't wait to see what you do next. And I'm really gonna miss being your coach. I think that's everybody. I got one more, I guess. Chris Carpenter. Chris, when you were 9 years old at the Acton Olympics, you did 51 push-ups in 60 seconds. You did 47 sit-ups in 60 seconds, and you held your low plank for 20 minutes. So you are now 18, right? So I'm not really good at math. So 9 times 2 is 18. So I think what that means is you should now be able to do 102 push-ups in 60 seconds, 94 sit-ups in 60 seconds, and hold a low plank for 40 minutes. Can you look me in the eye and tell me you can accomplish those athletic feats? Well, your cool feedback then is it sounds like we've got some work to do. New training regimen starting today after brunch. Warm feedback. This is the tricky part for me. So, when we were at the old Acton MBA school, where we had Acton over there, the field was kind of down below, and the classroom was around the corner. So whenever it was time for PE, I couldn't see you guys coming, but I would always hear you. Every single time you were leading the way, sprinting out as fast as you could towards me. Now, your sister, she'd be hanging back in the back all cool like that with her friends. But you were way too excited to be cool. And sometimes you'd turn back and you'd see if you had a little lead on everybody. It's just going to stay with me forever. So, but like Jeff and Laura, I was always worried I'd be too much, you know, in your grill. At school, you know, I wanted to give you your space, be with your friends, and I just didn't want to be too overwhelming. I know I got a big personality. And so I'd ask you, I'd say at the end of the year, I said, when you were 9 or 10, I said, Chris, if you don't want me to coach PE anymore, I'm happy to step aside. We can get somebody better than me in here, and, you know, you can learn some new stuff. And you looked at me, and do you remember what you said? You said, Dad, you're the best coach I ever had. And you're the only coach I ever want. So, your warm feedback is you sure know how to make your dad feel good. So my final thought for you guys is, coaching you and all you Eagles back there is the best thing I do. I just love it. People ask me what I do, and there's a lot of cool things I can say, right? Oh, I mentor entrepreneurs, I invest in startups, produce this movie. All that sounds pretty cool. But I don't say that. What I say is I'm a PE coach. And sometimes they give me a, you know, funny look, or they'll, you know, make kind of this snarky comment about it, right? And early on, it used to really get to me, right? And I would compensate for it. I'd say, oh, it's just, you know, temporary or whatever. But that's not the case anymore. Now, when someone asks me,
What I do, I say, oh, I'm a PE coach. Oh, and let me tell you about it. I love it. And then I start blabbing about it. Too long, usually. And I get two responses from people. First one's like, okay, psycho, we get it. You like it. But the second one is way more common. They see my energy. They see how much I love it. And they look at me and they go, man, I wish I had something in my life like that. So that is my only hope for you guys, is that you find something in your life that you love so much, that brings you so much energy and passion. It might be a hobby, it might be a career, it might be hair and makeup design, it might be photography, it might be filmmaking, it might be creative writing, it might be consulting acting academies around the world, or it might be filmmaking. But whatever it is, I hope you find it. Something that you love so much that no matter what anyone says, you don't care. You don't care what anyone thinks. Because when you find that, you'll be like your coach. You will be bulletproof. Okay, I know I promised no poems, but I have one to end. It goes like this. We are the... You know what? I don't think I should be the one to deliver this poem. Let's go. Hold on to your hats so they don't fall off. Listen, this is, yeah, circle up over here. Listen, this is your last chance before you get your diploma to do this. If you blow this, Chase might fire me. And I really want to come back and coach PE next year. Hey, listen, I mean it. Bring it. You guys ready? 3, 2, 1. Congratulations, graduates!
Just got some allergies, Jeff. It's not just a... sneezes over there. It is time to confer your Acton Academy diplomas. These represent so much more than simply your academic achievements. The Acton diploma is a badge of honor that represents a hero's journey of sacrifice, service, and perseverance. It is proof that you are capable, strong, and brave, and you are leaders who will lead with kindness and toughness, who will discover a calling that will change the world. I will soon call each of your names and ask you to please join me. Please remain standing next to me until each graduate has received their diplomas. Christopher Nicholas Carpenter. Luca Preston Jalapis Celestino. Caitlin Amelia Dishinger. Paige Faith Glover. Samuel Lee Sandifer. Evelyn Kate Williams. Chris, Luca, Caitlin, Paige, Sam, and Evelyn, together please move your tassels to the left side of your cap, a tradition symbolizing your transition from being Acton Eagles to Acton Academy graduates. Congratulations. Guests and Eagles, I will ask that you now rise. We will watch Chris, Luca, Caitlin, Paige, Sam, and Evelyn walk back out through this community one last time. Families of grads, please depart first so you can watch the Eagles cross the threshold. Eagles, we will soon follow you down to our symbolic threshold on the lawn, where you will pass through into your next great adventure and toss your caps and celebrate. Congratulations. Graduating Eagles, lead the way.
Hope when the moment comes, you'll say, I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all